Yay, we're live. How does it get any better than that? Now, what I need to do is work out how to get my chat box to pop out. How do I do that? So I can actually see what you guys are saying. Do, 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 do. Say hi in the chat box, guys. How does it get any better than this? Is it under there? Nope. Go live. Hi, Karen. Hi, Ramona. Hi, Evelyn. Now I just need to be able to get that to come out live so I can. Do-do-do-do-do. All right. I need to. What do I need to do to make this happen? Ah, I can't find it. How's it getting any better than this? Hello, Texas. You can see it. Yeah, I know I can see it, but I need to be able to read it while I'm over here. I need to try and make it bigger. Anyway, all right, let's get this show on the road. I'm gonna. Hey, Sherry. Mary. Yay, we've got trucks arriving. Typical, eh? I go live and all the trucks arrive. How's it getting any better than that? So, for those of you that don't know, my husband and I own and run a concrete placement company. And it's run from home. So, sometimes I have trucks turn up in my driveway at inappropriate times. So, I apologize for the truck noise if you can hear it. Heidi, hi. Yay. Awesome. And oh, that's all good. Let's do it this way. Let's just make my screen bigger. Okay. What's right about this, I'm not getting. Okay, guys, so what I am doing today is I'm going to be turning some of those lovely drip offs into pendants. So I've got a whole box. Drip offs. How's it getting in there? Better than that. So I've gone through and I've grabbed a chunk of them that I really like. And I would love some input from you guys as to which bits we use and stuff like that. I have put into the comments a link. It's late. I've put in the comments below, wherever that is to you, the links to the pendants and to the chains that I'm going to be using. If I can find them. Where did I put them? Oh. I thought I was so organized. My husband is about to drive to Auckland to do a job up there. It's a 3-hour drive. It's not normally where we work, but that's okay. So I'm going to put this onto so you can see what I'm doing. Less of me, more of my workspace. How does it get any better than that? So what I bought on Amazon, and I thought I'd buy it on Amazon because I There's all sorts of places you can buy these. But I thought, well, most people can get to Amazon, so let's use that. Put a link in the description as to what I hear you, but here no trucks. Awesome! Yay! Hi Michael, hi Sheila, Scotland, whoop whoop, you're up late. How's it getting any better than that? So what this kit has in it is pendants, square and round pendants. There we go. I might have to drop this down so you can see better. But it also comes with matching cabochons, which are the glass bits that stick over top. Now, when you're using these pendants, or any of the pendants, you can either buy the cabochon to put on and just glue that down on top, or you can fill it with resin. And I don't seem to have great results with resin. I get air bubbles and bugs and all, no matter how much I cover things and stuff like that. So I am playing with a different, I prefer to use the glass. A girlfriend of mine, I gave her a pendant for Christmas and she put it on and hasn't taken it off yet. And she showers in it, she goes swimming in it, she does all sorts of stuff in it. And that was glass and glue, like I'm going to show you today. And it still looks fantastic. So that's what we're using. I have glass and cabochon, and so we've got bronze and silver. Okay, this is not gonna necessarily be the easiest thing to do. I'm gonna lower this camera because it may be in my face, but it's, you'll get a better view. And the other things that I have here to work with is hole punches. Now, the hole punches that I have managed to find are almost perfect for these. So these are 25mm rounds and squares. Look, a round cabochon has gone in a square box, and yeah, they're both 25mm. So finding a circle and a square that are 25mm, and then you just chop them out, it's really easy. How does it get any better than that? And glue, what do I use for glue? I use where is it gone? Oh, I was so organized. There it is. I use the Araldite. It is ultra clear and it works on glass, china, metal, leather, rubber, wood, and most plastics. So I find that it's an epoxy resin adhesive, so it works like resin in that it seals really well, but it's also seals really quickly and glues, which is awesome. Now, so what do I want you guys to, oh, and you can get the oval ones as well, and they fit into the oval too, but don't need those. The other thing that I bought for the first time is these cords. And they come pre-thingied, so you can just slip that through there and voila, you've got a necklace. This pack comes with white, black and brown cables, and there are, I think, think I remember 60 in this pack, and it was like $8 plus shipping. So really, it's waxed braided. So there's no light. Damn. So wax braided. So that's a braided cable, and it's been waxed. The other way I do it is just with standard cable, and I double knot, the sliding knot option. I have some, and I can show you that. So this is a double knot option, and there's videos on YouTube on how to do this. But basically, what you end up is knotting. You're knotting this one around this one, so the knot slides, and so then you slide both to make it shorter or longer, just like that, and then you slide that one around there. And you end up with a shorter. So you can lengthen it to put it over your head and shorten it to make it whatever length you want it. Isn't that one pretty? No, I'm gonna have to drop it. Okay, I'm gonna drop this. So excuse me leaning around. Hey Nancy from Soy, Western Kentucky. Michael, I just thought I was finished with a pour and looked at it, and hundreds of little bugs lay in the resin. Oh no! I hate that. I hate bugs in resin. How long are the cords? So these bought ones, how long are they? I don't know. How long is a piece of string? Sorry. If you click the link on the in the description, Sherry, there's it will tell you. It takes you exactly to these products that I bought. So that one sits about there. I don't know how long they are. It says in the it says in the thing. With these cords, oh, cool. Thanks, Evelyn. Yeah, they do have different sizes. And the links in the description are really just to give you a sense of what I've bought, and then you can hunt around in your shops, in your on Amazon, or on all the other cheap shipping, AliExpress, etc. One of the things I have found with these pendants, the silver ones, being in Rotorua, we are a sulfur city, and they do tarnish. But when you're wearing them, it doesn't get tarnished if you wear them all the time. It's just if they're sitting around, exposed to the air and not being worn. So, hey Trudy from Texas. So I'm going to put the cords away because we don't need those right now. And what as I say, what I've got is I've got round and square, silver and bronze. And what I'm gonna say to you guys is, what should I put in them? And how much fun can we have playing with this? That's what I'm gonna ask. So this lighting is not great. Let me move that out of the way. What else have we got in the way here? plump. Check that out. It's inside a box. Anyway. I've got all sorts of little pory bits, and it's not... This is not going to be easy with the sun the way it is. So... I quite like this greeny gold one. The sun doesn't really capture it very well. There we go. And then there's a red and gold and green. So, okay, throw some colours at me, guys. What colours do you think I should play with? Color, any color. What have I got that's creating these giant shadows? Oh, that made a difference. Okay. Cool. Purple's your fave, says Trudy. Awesome! Cool. Thank you for putting it on and answer my question. Remind me to tell you about this stuff. Material. Purple's your fave. We should go with purple then. There's a purple one. Do you like that purple one? What else have I got in purple? I got that one. That one's pretty. Do you like that one? Trudy? I do. It's got silver in it. It's got sparkles. I've got so many different bits. I was like, oh, and I could do that one, and I could do that one, and I could do that one. It's so funny. This one's very metallic, but it's kind of got a purple hue to it. A shiny purple hue. I like that one. That round bit under your thumb is yummy. You said green and gold. That didn't show up. Round bit under my thumb. Do you mean this one? Like the blue with the big cells. So the other thing you need to bear in mind, guys, is how big the pendants are. Okay, they're not that big. So this one's really funky. And it's in a shadow. This one's really funky, but I reckon I need to find a way to be able to like make the whole thing into a pendant so that it's a bit long pendant. It's very cool, but it's just, it needs to be big. That pink shiny one is pretty too, says Trudy. Okay, cool. Where's my... This is going to be funny because you guys have got a bit of a delay. So Mary and Trudy both like the pink shiny one. Linda says yes, that one in my hand. Okay, so this one for Linda and this one for Trudy and Mary. Cool. Evelyn likes the pink shiny one too. Yay! Alright. These are all going to be for sale as well, guys, so if you get really excited about one in particular, bags it in the comments. I'm just going to sell them for $20 New Zealand, which is like 15 American, maybe, plus postage. So anywhere in New Zealand, that's like $3, but elsewhere, I don't know how much is postage for a letter? Because these would go be able to be sent as a letter. Oh, this is the other thing I wanted to show you. Quite often, instead of pouring my bits onto cardboard, I pour them onto my tiles and just leave them to dry. So I've got a couple of tiles here that I wanted to show you how I do that. It needs to still be quite thick, like don't pour it round so it's beautiful and big, but not very thick, because you need to be able to get your nail or some sort of utensil underneath and then peel it off. The cool thing about doing it on, you don't have to on cardboard because you just use the cardboard. If need be, you can put some water to help lift it if it's going to stick. And the longer it's been dry, the more it's going to necessarily break and crack. And like this one is. This one's been here for a long time. See, it's now cracking. Because the paint hardens. Almost off. But once you've got it off, you can then still cut it as if it was on cardboard. Okay, so there we have. I peeled it off. And I can now come in with my stamp cutter and find the bit that I really like. I can't see whether you can see this, because there we go. So find the bit that I really like and cut. Just like that, I have got a piece that fits pretty much perfectly into one of these, and I can just work that in with my nail, or another, a cuticle tool is also good if you don't have a decent nail. And then, so then you just, where is it gone? I'm such a klutz. There we go. And then you just glue that over top, and you've got a pendant. It's that easy, guys. Especially, Ramona says she runs a palette knife under hers. That's a good idea. That price is really reasonable. Thank you, Trudy. Yay. So there's one. All right. Put that over there. I'll glue them all together because it makes it a bit easier. What were we doing? Shiny purple. And that, yeah, I was just showing you that. So can piggle all those off. I really like this piece here. That's very cool. See that? Anyway. Shiny puppy purple. Where did my purple bit, that shiny purple bit go? Where did I move that to? Here it is. Yay! Now, if you don't have, are we putting this into, are we putting this in bronze square, bronze round, The bronze actually quite captures that colour in there. I think, I'm not sure if it's gold or what that is. So we're going gold, bronze or silver, and are we going round or square? Let me know. Yeah, freezer paper doesn't really exist in New Zealand. We have to buy it from somewhere weird. Wax paper. I haven't tried wax paper. Good idea, Trudy. I think I even have some. The only thing I can think of with wax paper is it tends to be quite crinkly, and you might get some unevenness going on about that. Michael says, I got the silicone cooking sheets, but only a resin pour works. And however you do it, if you're doing it with paint and you're going to be peeling it off, then you do need to make sure it's thick enough to peel. And also, when you peel it off, you get some funky stuff on the background too. That's beautiful. I love that. That's really amazing. Other times, you peel it off and you go, ooh, yuck. So the other option that I've used as well is these, I used to call them OHP sheets. They're clear plastic sheets. I actually have bought a packet of these for my Access Consciousness business. I do manuals, and I have my own binding machine. So I use these as front covers for my manuals, but they also work quite well. Not necessarily for peeling off. I haven't been able to peel off this, but again, you can just cut them out. See, there's quite a funky bit there. And again, I can just cut it out. And there's my piece. But you also get to see both sides. And that's the cool thing too, because this has got some really cool bits in here as well. And other times the underside is fugly. Oh, and the other thing that I've done, I'm just giving you all sorts of ideas, Costa, is let the paint that's left in the cup dry and then piggle it out. And I've got some examples of that here. This one is out of, where are we? This one's out of a cup. So the bottom's actually just really quite plain, but the top's got some fun and funky colour bits. And this is out of a cup as well, because quite often when you pour a cup, you get quite a cool result in the bottom of it, and you're like, oh, I like that. So you can piggle those out. Where have I got one that's ready to be piggled? I think these are all still quite wet. But yeah, piggle them out. Just piggle, 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 piggle. So there's lots of different ways that you can make skins. And you can use both sides. This one's been piggled out of the side of a cup, actually. It's got some beautiful metallics in it. But you can tell it's out of the side of a plastic cup because it's got the ridges from the cup. But it's pretty. And so you can just keep those between bits of baking paper like that. And I've just got sheets of baking paper that once I've piggled them off, I just slot them in. And then they don't stick to each other or anything else, which is quite cool. See, do you guys remember the video where I did a triangle and I hadn't cleaned it properly from a previous pour and the silicone pulled away? This is what I dipped I just set this piece of clear plastic on top. It was a really funky pour, but it had pulled away. So, yeah, I reckon I could cut some cool bits out of there. But that's the other side of it. It's not, it's interesting, but it's not so cool. Probably get something cool out of that. It's quite plain. The other thing I've got lying around is lots of bits of canvas that have cool bits on. I've not tried actually making pendants out of these, but I'm sure you can. I'm sure you can make pendants out of anything. So, where was that purple bit? There we go. Did we decide what colour we're doing it? Where's my mouse? Can't see my mouse. There it is. Scroll you up. I have to go fix dinner. Bye, Ramona. Yes, you have to watch it later. You bought donuts, yummy! Thank you, Poetic Angel Art. Trudy wants to tell me that she loves my accent. How did I get so lucky? But nobody's told me what colour to do my... put the purple bit on. Purpley, pinky, shiny bit. Shiny, happy people. I think I'm gonna probably go for that. So let me pop this back so that I can see what I'm showing you. So I've got my phone running into my computer, and on my screen I can see what I'm showing you. So the cool thing about using these is that you turn them upside down, take the little guard off, then they come with a guard like that, and take that off, and then you can slide your piece in and move it around until you find the bit that's pretty. Sometimes you need to get your scissors, if you can find them. And actually trim around your piece to get rid of all that excess, so that then when it goes into the cutter, but don't trim so much off that you can't move it like I just did. Come on. So you, basically what you see in that little window is what you're going to get. So I really, really like this like that. So I'm going to, but when I also do notice that over in this corner here, there's just a slight bit missing. So I need to shimmy it over so that the whole section is covered in paint. And then pop goes the weasel. So, see, this is done. I'm going to bring it down further. No, I can't do it that way. Sorry about the wiggle. I've actually got to drop my arm. So, if anybody's wondering, my setup is a standard camera tripod. and then taped to the handle that tilts your tripod up and down is a selfie stick with a phone holder on the selfie stick. How's it get any better than that? So there we go, now I can give you a better, hopefully. Now, these aren't quite perfect size-wise. I do actually need to trim them down. See, if I put that corner into there, it hangs over the edge. So this is where I then need to get my blade out. And I bought a new blade. Oh, I'm so happy. Look, I bought myself a scalpel, a proper precision design knife. Blade is very sharp. Odd that, blades tend to be very sharp. But it does come with a lid, so that's pleasing, and some spare blades. So, just protect my fingers. And then get my bit of cardboard, which I use as a cutting board. Where's it gone? Where are we? There. So, when you're cutting, I highly recommend using a metal ruler, not a plastic one, because otherwise you end up cutting the ruler. Are you guys still talk there? I'm seem to be, nobody's talking to me. Am I boring? Or are you just so engrossed in what I'm doing? So then I've got to decide which two sides I'm going to cut just a fraction off. I'm going to take it off that side because I've actually cut through one of these and it's just a tiny little blemish in the side there. And that side or that side? It's really weird because, you know, some of you might be aware that I use the Access Consciousness tools all the time, and I'm always asking questions about what should I choose, and I'm willing to follow the energy. I do like this new knife. And cognitively, my personal choice would be to cut this side off. But when I ask energetically, did it want me to cut this side or this side? I got this side. So that's where I'm going. That's right about that I'm not getting. Ah. Stay still. Not pushing down hard enough on the ruler. There we go. So there we go. It's now, no, it's not. Didn't cut enough off. I'm going to take some off this side, even though it said not to. So once I've done this like this, I'm going to show you the way you can do it if you don't have the little cutters. There we go, that fits in beautifully. And that bronze looks very much like that bronze. How odd.
Oh, bye, my darling. Love you.
Michael says you can send over some Fraser flavor. That's so sweet. Nate, entertained listening and watching, working on paintings at the moment myself. Yay! Oh, Sheila said something and changed her mind. Now, sometimes these pendants do have some imperfections. They are very, very large quantity generated. But the metal itself is really, really easy to cut. Just a sharp blade and it just trims them up. So there we go. So you could now go ahead and fill this with resin. Just be aware that if you are going to do resin onto a cardboard one or anything that's not just plain paint, you're going to end up with air bubbles coming out of the cardboard. So even if you get all the air bubbles out, it starts to get the air out of the cardboard itself. So yeah, be careful with that. Oh, Claire's tagged me in a post. How's it getting any better than that? Claire is one of our people on the acrylic pouring for fun group. So that one's going over there with a metal thing. Word of warning, when these arrived, I pulled them out and two of the square ones had corners had broken off. So, you know, just a word of warning. The thicker the thing that you put in here, the less of this that sits down into it. Like if I had nothing in there and put that down, you see that the bevel on the cabochon sits flat just there. But once I've got the cardboard in there, it sits up. And really, that's no problem. No problemo at all. So, what do you do if you don't have... Oh, yeah, I told you about the broken glass. So be careful when you open the packets because you don't want to cut yourself. So what do you do if you don't have these cool cutters that are the right size and shape? Definitely use cabochons, because if you're not using the cabochons, it makes it really hard to create the right size. But basically all you have to do is get your cabochon and glue it to the cardboard first. So you find where you want it to be and you glue it down. And when you're using this 5 minute epoxy, like honestly, it takes 5 minutes, oddly enough. And then once it's glued and it's staying where it needs to be, you just get your knife and cut round. And then if you've cut around the shape of the glass, it's just going to fit perfectly, no problem. So it's a really easy way to do it as well. But you do need to do it with the cabochons that way. These cabochons are crap. They have quite a few nicks and scratches in them. Doesn't matter, it's so much if the nicks and scratches are under here, because they'll get filled with the glue. But it's when they're on the top that you kind of go, ugh. And that's from them rubbing against each other in the bag. They'll probably put in their perfect condition, but by the time they get shipped all the way to New Zealand from China, that's what's happening. Evelyn, Walmart. What's Walmart? Who's at Walmart? We don't have Walmart in New Zealand. Food service uses what is called pan lines and nothing sticks. Yeah, they're awesome. can also buy them. They sell them in New Zealand as barbecue lining sheets. They are basically the same thing as what they use in the industry as pan liners. So, yeah, they are non-stick and they're awesome. Nate finds that the rectangle cabochons run a hair smaller. Small, is that smaller than the pendant? Or is that smaller than... I'm not really sure what you mean by that, Nate. Is it that they don't fit? Because if you look at this, this is not a perfect fit for this square, even though it's sold as a matching set. But once we put the glue in there, that glue will... The cool thing about using the epoxy glue is that it will fill all that space up and make it waterproof. A dot of resin can fix these. Oh, good point. Yep, great idea, fixing the corners on the broken glass with a dot of resin. Yeah. So once you, and that's, you know, that's the thing with these broken ones. If they're broken on the underside, once again, the, where is my broken ones? What if I just threw them away? I thought I'd kept them to show you. Now I can't even see which ones are broken. Maybe I threw the broken ones away. Or maybe they're hiding somewhere on my table. Check out this. I think this one's cool. Can you see? Look at this. I like that one. That one's cool. This whole page is quite cool, actually. Fun and funky. The other cool thing that the resin does, the epoxy glue does, is just like when you're varnishing, it adds that pop back into your colours, just like a varnish would. Alright, where are we at? Oh, crikey. We've been at this 50 minutes already. We've only picked out two. Any other choices on colours, combinations? Anybody want to pluck up the courage to suggest something? That's so cool. It looks like really scary teeth on the monster. Oh, you can't see it. This is frustrating. Can you see the teeth? Anyway, let me see if this. Let's get it into the shadows. So we've got greens. I find that's really funky. How cool is that? More purple. This one's a purple and black. I quite like that one too. There's another gold and green. Not so camera shy. It's a bit camera shy. There's my mom brain, which was that one. I'm not sure which one you mean, Nate. Which one did I show you that was gold, purple, and lime green? That one? It's not purple, but it's lime green and gold. It's more of an orangey red. That one's got no purple, but it's green and gold. Now I've shown you two green and golds, and I don't know. Do you mean this one? Which ones? Looks like the vase or yes. Yes, it does. So that one. Okay. Cool. We can do that. So what I'm going to do with this one is try and get some color. Hello. Here we go. So I'm going to do the glue on and cut around for this one. Should we go? Are we going to put that into bronze or into? Yeah, bronze. It's going to need to go bronze. One with the lightning bolt. He does look like a lightning bolt. Cool. Alright, so. And let's pick one more, guys. One more. What do we want? Let's go back over here so our lighting can sort itself out. So I've got. Honestly, if you start collecting your runoffs, you'll have hundreds of them. I mean, really, it's not hard. If you're doing painting, you're getting runoff. So just start collecting them. And then click on the links in the description. And I really like that one. That's cool. But I might wait till I've got some oval piece bits to put that into an oval one, because that would show a lot better. Purple. This purple, Angie. Purple on silver. Do you mean the black and. Or do you mean that one? Angie's in your head. Wah-ah-ah-ah. How does it get any better than that? I reckon this one would make quite a cool square silver. Purple with magenta. That one. Am I getting rid of that? Is that right? That one? Yes, 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 yes. Okay. I'm not really sure how much of a delay you guys have got, so it makes it a bit hard. actually just move all of these other ones over there and work here, because we seem to have good lighting in the shade. Yeah, yes, 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 do it. Okay, cool. So are we doing round or are we doing square? So we've got square or we've got round. Can you tell? Your phone is weird on colours. My eyes are weird on colours. Square or round? While you guys are coming up with that idea, I'm gonna find me a piece of plastic. Square, square, square. Square pigs, square pigs. You guys remember that program? Or am I just showing my age? Square. Alright. I've got my milk bottle out. So I'm just going to use my milk bottle for mixing my epoxy, because it's a two-part epoxy. And this is a 5 minute dry time, I think. So yeah, 5 minute setting time. So you don't have a lot of time to work, and I wouldn't do more than two at a time. So I'm gonna set these two up so they can be drying while I do the two that are going straight into here. And then they'll have time to have set up by the time to cut them out while we've done those. Does that make sense? I feel like my I'm a dilly billy, dilly dilly billy. How much fun can you have being silly? A lot. And that's my personal opinion. So in any form of two-part, when they come in a squeeze thingy like this, they're really easy, but it does pay just to have an even pressure, because otherwise you'll get uneven amounts coming out. So that's way too much, but that's okay. And then you just mix really well, just pretty much like you do with if you're doing resin. My art resin is a two-part, but just do it quickly, because otherwise it starts to set up. You've only got 5 minutes. So the way I do it is I smear it on the glass a reasonable amount and pretty much all over it. Don't have to be too accurate, because we're going to wiggle it so it'll sort itself out. And you don't have to be too thick either. Blast with the heat gun and then find your spot where you want it and squeeze. Squeeze, 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 squeeze. Trying to keep all resin off. Now, I keep a supply of, and you're all going to laugh at me when I say this word, because it's one of those words that Kiwis always get laughed at.
Pegs.
And I just have it like that, and it just squeezes that down and holds it where I want it. So I'm going to sit that over there while I grab this. And slop that onto there. And again, push and squeeze until get all the air bubbles out. I didn't use my heat gun on this one, so I've got some air bubbles in that. And now I've got some breath on my fingers. Pliggy, pliggy, plop, plop. Now the more you squeeze, the more air bubbles you're going to get out. Which is great because they all get pushed over to the side. And I can see. And sometimes when the cardboard is really being bendy and obnoxious, I'll get my metal ruler as a solid space to put behind it. This cardboard is a bit. No, that one's not gonna work. With the cabochons being rounded, I tend to find that these plastic pegs work a lot better. So let's let that one dry as well. Now, how's our glue going? It is still okay in there. Alright. Now, I've pushed these right in to show you, so that's not coming back out again. You can clean up the resin within sort of an hour, or the epoxy glue, within about an hour with white spirits, isopropyl alcohol, that sort of thing. When you're putting it into this bit, make sure you get right out to the edges. And I've left this glue just that fraction too long to be playing too much with it. But we'll get this done, it'll be fine.
Just chat amongst yourselves.
Silly, silly, dilly, dilly. Maybe someone's, everyone's off arting themselves. I like that arting. Okay, so once again, you need to squidge it around to make sure those air bubbles come out. Because you can't use a heat gun to get the air bubbles out like you can in resin. Um, I must say, this is one of the best purchases I've made, is a toothpick holder that has a hole that you can just tip one out. It's great. One-handed toothpicking. And just make sure it goes all the way around. This glues way too far around. And just clean off that large chunk. As I said, you can clean it up with isopropyl alcohol later. But try not to make as much mess as I am. How's it getting any better than this? Getting it all over everything. All over everything reminds me of you. Quite often I will mix my glue one thingy at a time, because otherwise you end up doing what I've just done, making a mess. How's it get any better than that? No, I'm not gonna drink, but this is my isopropyl alcohol bottle. Air bubbles are the worst. E6000, that's a type of glue I seem to remember. Yeah, permanent pendant. Who needs tattoos? Just super glue a pendant to your hand. How does it get any better than that? Kitty lock, can't get it off. Messes are fun till tidying up time. Yep. That's why kids never tidy up, because they are always into having just fun. I could never be a kindergarten teacher. Like, kindergarten in New Zealand is sort of 3 to 5 years old. I couldn't do it. They just play, get up and walk away. It's bad enough being a mother, but having to deal with 30, 40 kids at a time. Oh my goodness me, that would drive me insane. All right. Here we go. See, shiny. Doesn't take much, just shiny. I'm sitting here with this bottle of alcohol under my nose. I'm going to have to drive soon. That's probably not a good idea. Inhale. It's really, really important to go around and get any that you got onto the glass cabochon off, because once it dries and sets up, pretty permanent, like very permanent. As I said, my girlfriend's been wearing one of these since Christmas and hasn't taken it off at all for anything or anyone, and she is very happy with the results, because it doesn't let the water in, doesn't ruin the painting. So if you want to give somebody a cool present. Now these, this pendant pack was super cheap. I couldn't believe how cheap it was. You got 24 sets. And how much did I pay for that? So I got 24 sets of pendants for $10.94 American, and then the 60 necklaces, the 20 inch, those ones by the way, were $8.99. So all up delivered, you know, you've got 24 pendants with chain. Obviously, if you manage to get free shipping, even better. How's it getting any better than that? Sorry, I'm just reading your comments. So yeah, $20 plus shipping, and you've got 24 pendants to make. How's it get any better? That's on Amazon, Nate. So the links are in the description of this video. And if you buy it on Amazon using the links in my description, they are affiliate links, full disclosure here. And I get like 2% as a thank you for referring you as a client. How did I get so lucky? So if you buy from my links and you watch the ads before my videos, you pay me twice without it costing you anything. How did I get so lucky? All right. So that's that bit done. That's that bit done. Okay. Now, this is set up enough. Can't even see it. There we go. Set up enough for me to be able to cut that. All right. I'm going to have to be very careful not to wiggle it too much, but it's definitely... Oh, that is stunning. Let's see if I can get this thing. Check out that gold in there. Yum! Alright, so... I'm not normally this messy. Trying to get it all into the shop for you guys is not so easy. Okay, so make sure I've got clean fingers for this. Get my blade, and I'm just going to run that along the glass, using the glass as the ruler. Make sure you cut through the cardboard as well as the glue. I had one time and I let it set up quite a bit, and I thought, yep, I'm all done, and it hadn't even cut through to the cardboard. All I've been doing was cutting the glue, and as you can see, the glue is set enough to hold, but it's still jelly enough case in point, to cut with ease. So there we have a perfectly cut cabochon ready to go into its pendant holder. Give that a bit of a polish. Oh my goodness, that's so stunning. So hard to get cameras to take photos through a cabochon because it's rounded glass, reflective, blah blah blah. You have to come visit me, Linda. Or maybe enough if enough of you want me to come to the States, I could come and come over and do a course or something. Come over and kiss you all. I would love to. I would love to see you too. I love your comments, actually, Linda. I'm very grateful for all of you that comment on my videos. It's just awesome, 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 awesome. Can't get that to zoom in. What am I smelling? That weird smell of hot wood. I've got my fan heater going at my ankles. It was minus God knows how many degrees today when I woke up. The ice was thick on the top of the car. And yeah, smells like hot wood. But nothing's hot down there, so that's okay. I'm not gonna have burning feet, literally. So, once again, we're going to mix up some more glue, now that we've cut that out. Don't need anywhere near as much as I did last time. And mixy, 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 mixy. And it doesn't matter about the air bubbles this time, because what is it's all going to be underneath the cardboard. See how much easier this is to do than with that half set up glue that I was using last time, and just spread enough to cover. Oh, there we go. It's a better shot for you. Okay. And then we get our cabochon and decide which way around we're going to put it. That's something that is always good. Which way would you like to look at it? Which way would it make the most impact, the most beauty? I think that way. And again, wiggle, wiggle, wiggle. Get that glue up all the sides. So the target of getting the glue up the sides is to make sure that the edges of the cardboard is completely sealed. 'Cause cardboard likes water. And not in a good way. It's like an unhealthy relationship. So. Again, I'm gonna just let it set up a little bit and then go back in and clean it like the other one. So I will get these finished and cleaned up, and I'll pop photos in the acrylic pouring for fun group. Come on. There we go. Look at that. So it's going to hang that way. And there's your little lightning bolt through the center coming down to the ground. It's so hard to get these to show well. There we go, better. How's it getting any better than that? So I will get all four of those finished up. I'll probably do some more as well. What I also wanted to show you just real quickly before we go is another way of using these pendants is pouring directly into this. So what I did was I had paint left in my little pot after doing a pour, and I just poured it into it directly. And then, see, these ones come individually wrapped and they get a lot less. And then you just put your pendant cabochon in, glue it down, and you've got a beautiful piece. And it's not, you're not double gluing, you're not. But just information on doing it this method. This was full of paint, and then as it dried, it's sunk. As you know, when you're doing a painting, the painting sinks. It flattens, but it also shows up all the little indentations in the bottom of these pendants. Has these indentations, this little sort of spirally pattern. So you need to be aware of that. Make sure you've got really thick paint to, I mean, this one, even now, even though I filled it right to the very brim, I don't know if I can get it to show, but there is a slight indentation. So that one's not too bad. That one's gonna look beautiful. I was actually wearing I was wearing the last pendant that I did similar to this, and somebody went, "Wow, I love your pendant," and I went, "It is for sale," and he bought it off my neck, literally. Just, I was in town and he bought it off my neck. Just also be aware, some paints don't, some of them doing this don't work, you know, like this one's got a crack in here, but it's not very obvious. You could fill this with resin and nobody would even know. It's pretty cool. I quite like that one. Again, poured out of the bottom of a tin. And there's another one, and it's done the same thing. It's not flat enough to put a cabochon over, so I'm gonna have to resin it. And you can see, maybe, that bit there is starting to pull away from it. So then, you know, you're just gonna, when you resin it, make sure that it fills in the gaps. It's really no big issue. What else? I've been playing with making pendants without bezels. And I've got a video on my channel about that. I'm not having huge amounts of success. This is with resin, double siding, but then I haven't been able to work out how to resin the edge without getting weird lumpy bits. So if anybody has done anything like that and you've got some ideas, my last resort that I haven't tried yet is to just fit the fitting and then hang it from the fitting and literally dip it into resin. But then I'm really worried that you're going to end up with a hanging over the end bit where it's dripped. But then you could just make that look funky and intentional, and that'd be fine too. So there you go, guys. I'm gonna call it a day. We've had an hour and 25 minutes online today, and I've had lots of fun with you guys. And those of you that have stuck out for the whole hour and 25 minutes, I am super duper 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 impressed. But I just want to say thank you so much to all of you who come and play with me on my channel, who comment on the channel, and those of you that you know, are willing to watch 30 seconds of the ad at the beginning of my thing. Yay, thank you. I do get a small token that just manages to cover my paints each month from Google for those ads. How does it get even bigger and better than that? Yeah, I am not very good with molds. I don't know, it's just my molds are cheap and yucky, but yeah, molds don't seem to work for me either. I have played with it. Yeah, and I'm not very good at getting my paintings up online ready to be sold. So if you do come across any paintings that you would love to own, please touch base with me. And let me know which one you'd love, and I'm happy to let you know how much for postage and sort that out. So thank you all for joining me. I adore you all. Maybe the storms will go away, Linda, but you know, the planet requires to be able to do these things. Thank you for making my art fun time fun. Yay! Mwah. I adore you all. Have fun. And what else is possible? What else can you choose today that will add fun to your life, your living, and your reality? And if you haven't already joined us, please come join us on Acrylic Pouring for Fun and play with us and have some fun and show us what you've been creating and all of that stuff. So, have fun. I adore you. Bye-bye.